Another question that came through last Sunday was from chapter 9 of 1 Corinthians, verse 23 and following. And the question was this: how does one become disqualified for the prize? Is it speaking about a salvation issue, or is it referring to receiving less reward, fewer rewards in the kingdom of heaven? Now, this is where paying attention to the context is super important. I don't think Paul is speaking about either salvation, losing salvation, or about losing rewards. Earlier in our series, I actually recorded a Q&A video in which I explained why I think it's mistaken to imagine that there will be degrees of reward in the kingdom of heaven. Rather, we will each share in Christ's own crown as a reward in the kingdom. There is no greater glory that you could add on top of that, of being crowned with Christ's crown. But neither is Paul speaking here about being disqualified from salvation. Rather, he is concerned to not disqualify himself as a preacher of the gospel, as one who shared in the blessing of promoting the gospel message, as Paul says in chapter 9, verse 23. Paul goes on to say, what good is it if he preaches the gospel with his mouth, but at the same time emboldens weak believers to return to their idolatry and sin by the carelessness, the ill-disciplined exercise of his own freedoms? He is anxious, Paul is anxious, that after preaching to others the gospel, he doesn't disqualify himself as a preacher of the gospel by emboldening others to sin through his actions. Paul's comment about only one person winning the prize isn't suggesting that Christians are competing with each other in any sense. Rather, just as winning a race requires deliberate and conscious discipline, so it takes deliberate and conscious discipline for Paul to not undermine his preaching by how he uses his freedoms in how he eats or whether he accepts support for the work of an apostle, those kind of things. I hope that helps a little clarify Paul's question about being disqualified from chapter 9 of 1 Corinthians.